Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and today I'm coming to share with you my purse journal. It's like a full year journal, and I used cardstock, fabric, and also leather with those metal closures for my cover. And it has two spines, one is here and other one is here. This is just for decoration, this zip. There is no any pocket in there. Here we've got a pen holder, and it's decorated with those beautiful, I think it's daisies, those flowers, or maybe those sun. I don't remember the name of those flowers, but they are always turning behind the sun. So it's opening with these closures. And I used wonderful, amazing, beautiful paper from Anna's Design. It's English shop. I found that they've got really beautiful papers. I think now, probably they are changing it every 2-3 months. They've got now these beautiful shabby chic papers. This is in peach color. They've got in cocoa, in coffee, I think. Beautiful papers with wonderful vintage design. Very shabby chic. I will put link for this shop down below, or I can show you. It's here. And they've got so many amazing cardstock things for mixed media. It's a really wonderful shop. So I use it for my cover. And it's open like this. And like this. I didn't make any pockets here or here. Because I wanted to have this one like nicely. Nothing will fall down. Here we've got those pockets. It's four pockets here. Side pockets. Here can be store some cards, business cards, bank card, anything, gift cards, anything you want. And I've got that these beautiful ladies in these pockets. And then we've got that journal. In first pocket, I've got, it's decorated with this lovely picture of Victorian lady. And here we've got, I really like this cabinet card. I love that picture of that kid. It looks so amazing. So we've got this cabinet card, and here is just some ephemera, like this, and it's holding with this paper clip. It's in first pocket, and I was thinking, I'm horrible with writing down my diary or planner or something like this, and I was thinking how likely I will do that, but I'm not, and which composition I will probably choose for myself, if I will find some time for writing down, which composition I will use for myself. So it's a little bit like it's in this journal. It's actually a full year planner or a notice book. It has beautifully done planning sections. It's always one full week. It starts Monday and it's finished Sunday, and here is small notes section. All papers are coffee dyed. Few papers are sewn together, so there is large gap, large pocket like here. And because I was thinking that to use this book for a full year, and you know, sometimes we've got something very special in that month, and we want to like place it on special place, but still in that journal. So I made for every single month, I made small pocket. It has a name of that month, and when you open it, you've got space for writing here. And when you open this one, this window, you've got pocket here. It's a very beautiful, simple pocket, and I really like that. It's made from one envelope. This is backside, so you've got journaling section here. And I've got 12 of them, one for every single month. So if you've got something very special in that month, you can print out some photography or save tickets from concert, or maybe put there a dry flower from your garden. you know, something special, so you can place it in that pocket. So, and here is that journaling writing section. Here you can see it's those large pockets. It's just few of them in this journal, and those pages are pretty similar. Here we've got large pocket here, and I've got there slide this ledger paper, I believe, here. Yes, here is this ledger paper. This beautiful cabinet card, and just this is actually a cabinet card as well, I think. It's called, it's from Tim Holtz die. Here we've got February, and it's exactly same system, just turn it on the side, and then we've got pocket, and it's holding with this paper clip. It's February. Again, those pages, those planner pages are same. I coffee dye them, so they've got beautiful pattern from both sides. There is few tags, and you will see I used loads of times today. This time I used a lot my new sewing machine. By the way, I had so many questions, how many papers and what my machine can sew together. So I tried 4, 8 and 12 sheets of papers. Those 12 was 100 grammage letter paper, and then I sewed together. This is cardstock, it's pretty good cardstock. It's not some it's some thick some thin. It's good cardstock sewn together with paper, with fabric. With paper and fabric, it was good. And then I saw, I'm gonna show you if I will find it. Then I saw leather together with pizza box without any problem. Just where you've got stitching from your fabric, like is here. On this jeans journal, it's not finished yet, and it will be for sale, but I'm taking time. It will be full of those paper doilies. So here you can see that I did stitching. I stitch so many papers together, but when you stitching thick layers, just go with that slow motion with the slow sewing, or make it sewn through to those thicker already stitch pieces. Go with your hand with that side circle, and that machine I showed you, it's totally amazing. So I'm using it a lot now, a lot. as you can see, a lot. I'm really enjoying this sewing machine here. I'm not perfect yet, but I really enjoy it. So here we've got pocket, this small tab. This ephemera, it's holding with paper clip from this side. It's this cabinet card with lady, and we've got again ephemera. This and then we've got May again, few pages. Here you can see I sewn even my tags I did sewn. Here we've got July, and all of them are similar. Just turn this to the side, open, you've got space for writing, flip it up, and you've got pocket, so you can save something there. And you can see that through to that window, which I think it's totally amazing. I really like those window envelopes. Again, few pages for journaling, and I didn't decorate it too much because, you know, when you are going through to that year, it's so many things you can find, you can wanna save. And if those pages will be decorated too much by me, you will don't have a space to stick there tickets from theater or from cinema, or, you know, the recipe from some amazing restaurant you've been there. So I left it like it is, just shown. I've got few decorations, but it's mostly can be take off, so it huge possibility here to here it's huge space for your creativity. I can't even tell that. Here we've got pocket with just this beautiful drawing of lady. Here we've got two tags, and again those papers. I think, oh, I need to place something inside. Here we've got August, this beautiful lady. Here we've got clock card with this ephemera. Oh, not ephemera. This cabinet card. Again, few pages for journaling. September. These are really gorgeous months. Very beautifully done. I've got them from my friend from Russia. I made few swaps while ago. I think it's 2 years ago when I made few swaps. And I've got few videos about those swaps. And Natasha Kinsky, she sent me many beautiful things. And I placed... I'm always placing all boxes from my friends under my bed. And I decide, oh, I'm going to sort it out. And I found those boxes from long past in large box. So I placed them alongside and I'm starting to use them. And she sent me also these. I'm not sure if they are from Russian designers, but they are really gorgeous. Also those, where they are, here, those. She sent me those beautiful cards, so I'm gonna use them finally, because I found them. Here we've got just tag and this photography. Again, those weekly cards. Here we've got beautiful picture tag and this label or cabinet card. Here we've got another beautiful photography. And I can say that journal smells so good because I used on that leather, here on that leather, I used a little bit of wax I've got now from my wonderful friend Evie. Thank you so much, Evie. It's amazing and it smells so good. It smells like my grandma perfume. It has, I don't remember name of those flowers, but I will have to have a look. How to say that in English. These are very small white flowers. And it was famous perfume for old people in my country. It is really. It is marked like perfume for old people. But it smells so good. And this one smells exactly the same. It's Prima. This Opal Magic Wax. It's really wonderful smell. So that journal smells like this. Here we've got another beautiful picture here, October. Again, few tags, lace. Here we've got this lady with tag. Come on, go there. So as you can see, here is so many pockets and so many space for writing. Not just if you wanna write in those columns exactly what you did at that day, just small notes, and then you wanna maybe drawn something. You've got blank pages as well, so it's brilliant. Here we've got this beautiful picture, and there is loads of space for decorating, loads of space how you can make your journal. It has proper full year here in those papers. Here we've got last pocket with this beautiful picture, and here is one cabinet card. I used so many colors to decorate it. And here is another one. I tried to put it there same color like is here, but it's a little bit more brighter. Mine. I didn't want to destroy it then, so I left it like this. Oops. So this is my journal for today. I will place it on eBay. And I will have there few more. Few of you asked me if I can make just blank journals. You know, just like a skeleton of journal. If I can say so. So I stopped creating with two of them. And I hope those two ladies, I can't find these comments now, because I don't remember under which video it was. So I hope these ladies will see that I already have on my eBay this one. I saw you. Oh, mine. I showed you how to make these embossed covers. And this journal has pockets inside. It has pockets here. It has writing pages. And it has really so many pockets. They are already decorated with vintage paper. With proper vintage paper, by the way. It's paper from 1908. From a book which fall apart. So I use them here. Here, pockets. So this is blank. Blank journal, ready for your decoration, ready for your fantasy, for your creativity. Decorate it with your memories, with your favorite papers. Here another pocket. And it's closing with this chain. So this I already have there. And then I've got one. And because I lost, you know, I lost that, that line, how I want to continue with this. And I like this journal, but now I don't know how to continue. So I decide I'm going to place this one like half blank. I'm going to show you. It's journal where I used those file folders. So here I use it like on spine. So here can be still hung some laces or something. It's open here and it's magnetic. So here you got space for maybe photographies or maybe some secret notes, I don't know, passports or passwords, no passports. And it's closing on magnet. And when you open it, you've got a section here. When you turn this, you've got a multi-pocket. This is multi-pocket made out of envelope. And it's open like this. And you've got so many pockets here. It's for credit cards, for photographies, for notes. So it's on this side. Here you've got windows, two windows here. Here. When you open it, come here. You've got similar pockets here on this side. When you open this bottom, you've got very tall pocket. It's tall like this from here and exactly same tall pocket here. But you don't have to be scared that you're gonna destroy your paper because these pockets are separate. Those papers will not match together. This is one pocket and this is another pocket. And here you've got, you know, like sliding tags. So you can slide picture behind or some note behind. So this is multi-pocket section here. And one pocket, it's teeny mini pocket here behind all this. And it's holding with those two tabs. Here we've got writing section full of pockets, papers, windows through. So even if you will write down something here, you can see that. Oh, here I think I will paste. It's half done. Papers, pockets. Again, papers. Here, those envelopes. So as you can see, it's a lot done, but not too much. And I lost that you know, that line. I'm not sure how to continue now. Again, window pocket, where you can see through what you've got on that other side. These papers. Another pocket. So it has loads of pockets, loads of papers for writing. It's really, I think, beautiful, beautiful journal. But right now I am in that jeans, in those paper dolls. And I think it will be shame. And we've got pocket here. It will be shame if this journal will sitting here. So this journal will be there like half blank. They've got these three journals for sale now on my eBay. And now, just small note about that licensing for Victoria Design. Yes, I found out finally all answers for my questions. You can buy all digitals from this Victoria Design, and you can use it for your swaps, for gifts, for your family, friends. But you can sell it without without license from this shop. But you have to buy this license just once, and then this license it's for all images, all digitals, all kits you will ever purchased from Victoria Design. And I totally understand it's their protection, they need to do something. I fully understand why they do it, and I still think that these collections worth to buy it, because they are amazing, they're amazingly done, they've got very special design, very special design. So even for swaps in our groups, you know, even for swaps, these designs will be wonderful, wonderful. And Victoria Design always make, I'm not sure if is it every month or every 2 weeks, they have sales for some kit. Now it's their lavender sale. Go to have a look, because these images are so amazing, really, so amazing. So these are my journals. They will be, links will be in the description box below. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my journals, if you like any tutorial from the past, please share it with your friend. Share my name with my work if you like it, please. And I will do my best to bring something new again. Thank you so much for your watching. Thank you so much for your supporting. Have a beautiful day and see you next time. Bye.